Excellencies, esteemed partners, ladies and gentlemen, COP26 must show that we both understand what is needed to advance the 1.5 goal and that we are willing to do what needs to be done, that we need to move from ambition to accountability. We need to cut emissions drastically, and we need to do it now. Our planet is in a state of emergency. It's a climate crisis, bringing an increased number of storms, floods, wildfires and droughts, a biodiversity crisis with an accelerating extinction of species, raising sharp questions about how our livelihoods depend on our relationship with nature. And as we are destroying our ecosystem services that we depend on, and on top of it, an inequality crisis exacerbated by the socioeconomic effects of the global pandemic, again, disproportionately affecting those who are already most vulnerable. And we know climate change not anymore as a threat of tomorrow, but as the greatest threat we face as humanity today. So we urgently now need to enhance climate change adaptation all over the world, especially in the most vulnerable countries. And therefore, we need to boost adaptation finance to meet the needs on the ground while also improving quality and ensuring accessibility. It is increasingly important to consider the rapid loss of biological diversity, ecosystem protection and restoration, as well as to prevent that the effects of climate change leads to societal tensions, food insecurity, and ultimately conflict. My government recently announced that we intend to double our climate finance to mitigation and adaptation until 2025. And Sweden's climate aid is roughly equal between adaptation and mitigation. However, globally, climate adaptation is underfinanced. And we as donors have to honor the $100 billion commitment. And that's a matter of trust and of accountability. Sweden is also a financial supporter of the GCA's Africa program since its start in 2020, and we intend to continue to support the GCA in Africa. As we are determined to cut our own emissions, to move from pollution to solution, let us work together to enhance climate change adaptation globally, and especially for the communities most vulnerable. Friends and partners, partnership is leadership. Thank you very much.